Hi, everybody. Happy Tuesday. So today we're going to talk a little bit more about stocking our pantry. Yesterday we started off with different things to look at. I strongly encourage you to spend some time going over those recommendations. Get a pad, get a pencil, and go there and look at what's there and talk to your family and see what they would like to be there so that you can better figure out what to buy long term, okay? Especially when it comes to the spice cabinet. Now, how to figure out what to buy. That becomes the tricky part because you don't want to waste money on food that you're not going to eat, but at the same time you want to be able to stock up so that you have enough so that it's there. And tastes are going to change throughout the year. I mean, we're a prime example of that. We will eat something gangbusters at least once a week, you know, for a month or two, and then we won't touch it again for six or more months. And it just tastes change depending on the season, depending on the dietary needs, a lot of different things. And with kids, it truly is a crapshoot as to what they're going to feel like they like this week and what they're not. I get that. I understand that. But try to hone it in as best as you can. Okay. there are a couple of prepackaged foods that we do eat here. Actually, I think there's about three. Okay. And those are the kinds of things that, you know, I want to buy in bulk and have set aside because we use them. I think you've heard me mention before the cream of mushroom soup. I make sure to purchase it when it goes on sale because the price is almost half off and I know that it won't go to waste. First is because it's an ingredient in a lot of different things. It's an ingredient in casseroles and pot pies and that kind of thing. And that's good when we're doing when the whole family is here for dinner, there's more than just the two of us, we will utilize that because it beefs up that meal for the seven people that are here. But then Phil also eats it for lunch or dinner if I'm not home. He'll have that cream of mushroom soup. So it serves two different purposes. So we know that we're going to eat it. I don't track lunches so much as I try to track dinners when it comes to meal planning. Lunches, it's catch as catch can, and we just try to have things on hand or eat leftovers from the day before, whatever suits our mood. We're both odd eaters when it comes to lunch. A couple of sticks of beef jerky and a thing of cheese sometimes. You know, it depends on what you're doing and what you feel like that day. There's no big meal involved. And breakfast is normally, for me, coffee, and for Phil, sometimes cereal. So, cereal, that's the other thing. Gotta think about cereal. See, until I say it, I don't always remember it because I haven't looked in my cabinets yet. I'm guilty. But, so we're going to take, okay, so we've got cream of mushroom soup. We've got tuna because I don't have any tuna growing here in Michigan. So I do buy tuna fish. Typically the canned and water kind, okay? I prefer the cans over that bagged thing that doesn't have any liquid in it. While that has its purpose and its convenience, that's not pretty much what I want to be able to store for a long-term thing. And I looked at the cans of tuna because I picked some up this week and they are good until 2019 sometime. So I know that I can go back and pick up more tuna. Now, how much more tuna am I going to want to pick up? Well, not counting the budget thing, just looking if I want a year's worth of tuna, okay? It's something that we both like. It's something that we can eat for lunches. It's something that we can even eat on occasion for dinner. The kids and Phil love tuna noodle casserole, you know, so on occasion that'll happen. So let's average it out here. There may be some weeks that we don't want some. Let's say start. Okay, tuna. Sometimes I have to reset. So we're going to go with this one item. There are 52 weeks in a year. At least once a week, we will have tuna fish for lunch. Okay, and we'll just say a can of tuna. One can of tuna once a week for 52 weeks. Poof, right there. That's 52 cans of tuna. Now, if we're each having a can of tuna for lunch, then that's two cans of tuna per week for 52 weeks. That's 104 cans of tuna. I'm pretty sure that we can eat more than that. How's that for scary? But we're going to stick relatively close and say, let's go with three cans per week for 52 weeks. I think that's a fair assumption, okay? Because again, it'll go in spurts. I may eat it five times a week and then not touch it for a month. So we're going to say three. So we've got 156 cans of tuna is what I want to put in storage. And now that I say that out loud, I actually kind of want to put more, you know, so, but we're going to use that for example. Okay, so 156 cans of tuna at what price? Now, I just grab tuna, guys, and typically it is one of the cheaper brands. So I know that right now I can get a can of tuna for about 70 cents, okay? So let me grab my calculator here. So if we're looking at 70 cents times 156 equals, that's $109.20 for over a year's worth of tuna. How much do I really want that much tuna? Okay, let's factor that in. There's got to be other stuff to eat, right? That's expensive when you consider that an entire pint of chicken costs me $1.49 right now. So that's pretty expensive. That's more than twice as much chicken for double the cost of tuna. That's okay. Might have to rethink how much, so maybe I'll go back down to 52. See, this is where it gets tricky. This, you can spend time debating back and forth. I highly recommend a pencil, not a pen, okay? So if we do 52 cans of tuna times 70 cents, that's $36.40. Did I do that right? Times 52, $36.40. We go, yeah, you know, so 72.80 is 104. But you're stocking your pantry and you won't have to buy it again for another year, right? Maybe you can find a coupon. But that's what you need to look at. That's what you need to try to figure out when you're figuring out how far in advance do you want to do this. I grabbed a year because, you know, that's my goal. I want to have at least a year's worth of food in the pantry. But if you want to take it down a little bit and say 6 months, and then that is totally doable, and you might be able to increase, whoop, I just closed my calculator, you might be able to increase how much you have a week. So if you were to do twice a week for 26 weeks, then that's the original 36.40, okay? 36.40 is much more manageable when you think about it. Just that, so you don't get that sticker shock, because when multiplying your food like this for a long time can actually give you sticker shock, but it will encourage you to more closely watch what you're purchasing and what you're actually stocking up, okay? And again, check the shelf life. I told you about the Cheerios thing. I mean, it has a shelf life. It will go bad, I promise you. So, tuna, peanut butter has a shelf life, but again, it's normally a pretty decent shelf life. So you want to go through, figure out the sizes. Like I gave an example yesterday, I believe, one of those 4 pound cans of Jif, okay, is roughly $11 to $12 where I'm at. And we would go through one of those a month, give or take. There are, you know, some months more, some months less. But if I were going to stock up on peanut butter, for a year, then I would go buy 12 of those. So I know that's going to be $144 worth of peanut butter. But you can budget it out that way, okay? And you don't have to do all this at once. My goodness, you would go broke in a heartbeat. Go for those smaller time increments. Go for 3 months. First stock up on 3 months. Figure out your list and stock up for 3 months. And then when that's all done, revisit your list and stock up for another 3 months. And then revisit your list and stock up for another 3 months. And do it when you can afford to do it, okay? Catch the sales. Watch how the prices are fluctuating. Once you really pay attention to how those prices go up and down, you can kind of gauge. Like I did with the January Pantry Challenge. I just knew that they were due to go on sale with the cream of mushroom soup because I'd been watching the pattern of when they do it. I knew it was coming. So once you watch that kind of thing for a little while, you'll be able to gauge the pattern that they're doing. Now, the tricky part, spices, okay? And some of this is a live and learn. You have to actually go through it to figure it out. First menu plan, you have to know what you're dealing with. Then figure out how much you would actually use of any particular item. And it's stuff that you currently have in your cabinet that you wish was in your cabinet, or the wish list that I told you to try to put together. You know, if you were to be stranded for 5 days, what kind of food would you like in your house? Spices are still the tricky one, but if you store them properly, they're not going to go bad really quick, so you'd be good, okay? Those 5 gallon buckets, here that you can get them from Walmart for about $1 if you go visit the bakery section. If you visit your bakeries or any of your food establishments locally to where you are, you might be able to convince them to give them to you or sell them to you. We have a bakery here that sells them for like $2.50, okay? 3 gallon buckets for $2.50. Or you can actually go and order them brand new online. You want to make sure that they are food grade buckets, okay? Now, when you're storing your spices and stuff in them, if you're buying in bulk, and there's a company I'm going to have to refer you over to, I'm So Instagram, it's a company that she uses that I still need to check out, that ship spices to you. So I will try to link that video up tonight. And order them in bulk when you can, when it's affordable, okay? You can never have enough garlic powder or onion powder or pepper or salt. You know, the basics that you know that you're going to use. If you decide to make your own taco seasoning, then chili powder and cumin. Those are something that you want to buy in bulk. You know, like a 1 pound of spices, and see how long that lasts you. Now, what I'm suggesting the bucket for is because you're going to pull out and you're going to fill your little jars, okay? You're going to fill your jars or your containers that may or may not hold, you know, so much. When it comes to like that taco mix, it tends to clump up if you don't put it in a really good airtight container once it's mixed together. So I wouldn't build too many of those, you know, unless you know you're going to do 4 taco-type meals in a month, and go ahead and make up 4, but you're going to have to do something to break it up when you get to it. But then you want to put those into something that's airtight, that doesn't have a lot of light hitting it, that won't get moisture in it, and that's where these buckets come into play. You can either use the buckets that are already, or the lids that are already with the buckets, or you can order gamma lids. Now, I did find that our local hardware store is a little bit cheaper on gamma lids than Amazon, so it doesn't hurt to ask if your local hardware store can obtain them if they don't already carry them, or go onto Amazon and look up gamma lids, G-A-M-M-A. And those are handy and convenient and wonderful. You just twist them off. You don't have to fight that lid to come off, because it's difficult, and the older you get, the more difficult it is. So you want to be able to store them in there. Now, what I do, if you're looking at a year or less, is I just put a black trash bag into those white buckets, okay? And then I put the stuff inside. The black trash bag will help keep the light exposure down, and then you're in the bucket and it's sealed up and you don't have to worry about the rest of it, okay? But you want to make a list on the outside. Tack a piece of paper on there, so make a list of what's in there so that you know, so that you use it, okay? But if you're looking at longer term storage than a year, I would definitely recommend checking into Mylar bags. They come in all different kinds of sizes. They're on Amazon, and looking at using a food saver, get a food saver. But I have actually seen a few people that use an iron. I don't know that it did, well, obviously it doesn't. It doesn't pull the air out like a food saver would, okay? But it does seal it closed. So I don't know how pertinent that is. You could put in oxygen absorbers, maybe, and then seal it closed with an iron. So, you know, if you don't want to spend a lot of money on extra equipment that you just are not totally in love with yet, then use what you've got. But Mylar bags, for anything longer than a year, I would highly recommend. You don't want to vacuum seal the Mylar bag with the powdered herbs and whatnot in it, unless they are sealed in on something else, because it will suck the powder through the vacuum sealer, and it's not a good thing. It's bad, okay? So that's one you're gonna have to play with. But to buy a pound of whatever spice, unless it's some, you know, crazy exotic spice, is not a bad investment. You're going to use it. It will always be on hand. You might use more of it now that it's always on hand, okay? So you're not gonna go wrong there. But again, this is something that you tiptoe into. Do a few things, okay? I catch, there's a ragu Alfredo sauce that, when I broke down the carbs, is great. It's remarkably convenient for me. and it's one of the few actual processed foods that we take in because of its convenience and it tastes good. I know it's easy to make Alfredo sauce. I really just, guys, I gotta pick and choose my battles, you know? So when I see that that is, gosh, it's over 60 cents cheaper in Dollar General than it is in any grocery store in my area. So when I go into Dollar General and I'm on a mission to stock my shelf with this, I will go in there and pick up 10 plus jars of this. I'm actually making plans to pick up 26 jars of this because I ran out. There's none on the shelf. Phil is really in the mood for Alfredo lately. I've been doing a venison broccoli Alfredo, which is a crazy super simple meal for me to do. And so there's, you know, it's hardly any cost. It costs, well, the deer costs almost nothing. Excuse the phone. The deer cost, you know, the price of going out and hunting. And the broccoli cost me about $1 a bag because I use frozen broccoli. And then this Ragu Alfredo sauce cost me about $1.80. So you're talking $2.80 per meal. And typically that's a two-person meal. So it's 90 cents per meal. How crazy is that? I just fed my husband for 90 cents, a dinner that he loves, okay? And if I'm feeling really generous, I'll put in a slice of homemade bread with it, okay? But I just fed my husband for 90 cents. And that's not a small portion. He's crazy full. So if you were to break that up for more people, you know, you're doing great. Because I don't even use the whole bag of broccoli. So, I digress again, as usual. So that's how you break it down by weeks first, okay? So find out what you like to eat. Figure out how many times you want to eat that per month. Figure out what all the ingredients are for that meal, okay? And then figure out how many jars or bottles or cans or whatever that you need. When it's something like a condiment, I err on the side of caution. I will put 12 bottles of Worcestershire sauce in the pantry, or 12 bottles of soy sauce, or, you know, any of the condiments like that. Mustard, I'm down to two bottles of spicy mustard in there, but we slow down on the spicy mustard this time of year. So my goal is to have 12 of all of those things in there, because a year you can't go bad. If you figure you use one a month, great. If you don't, that's fine. You can extend that list out. So this is not something that you're going to figure out. I kind of feel like I'm rambling, and I really hope that I'm not. But you need to sit down and live it for at least a month, probably two. Get that pen, get that paper, make those lists, do that math, and you take an educated guess. That's really what you're doing, an educated guess. I'm coming really close to 20 minutes here, so I don't want to lose any of you, but I take a really great educated guess, kind of like the toilet paper, you guys. I think this is what we might use, and so this is what I'm going to put in the pantry. And then in a year, I can look back and go, I ran out in month 10, or wow, I've got enough to go another couple months. And then you readjust from there, okay? Better safe than sorry, in my opinion. And this is a process that's going to take you, unless you hit the lottery, a couple of years to do, okay? So don't stress over it, because again, it should be fun. It should be fun. It's necessary, but it should still be fun, and you can have a lot of fun with this. Nothing feels as good as putting those jars on a shelf. Nothing feels as good as stocking those cans and those bottles onto the shelf, and nothing feels as good as stacking that toilet paper in the corner. Okay, so it's money in the bank. It really, really is money in the bank. And so I will go without a couple things right now to know that I've got that set aside there. It's one less thing that I have to worry about, and I know if anything happens, we've got that cushion. And while I don't encourage you to live in fear, because that's a god-awful way to live, okay, I encourage you to be aware that things change and things happen. And so to have that set up there is huge, okay? So what I'd like to know is, if I didn't answer something, if there's a question that you have because of this, can you leave it in the comment section below? Because I will take this to a part three. I'll give it a couple days, you know, for everyone to see. But that to me is how you do the math. You find out what you like. You figure out how many times a week you want to eat that, or how many times a month you want to eat that, you multiply it by that amount, and that's how much you buy, and that's how much you put up there. Be aware of the dates that are on a lot of this stuff. Know the difference between a sell-by and a use-by date, which I understand there might be some legislation coming up making it easier to understand. Figure out how to make things yourself, and whether or not it's worth your time and effort. Okay, I use taco seasoning and Alfredo sauce as an example. Okay, taco seasoning to me is totally worth it. It's absolutely worth it. The Alfredo sauce, not so much. Not so much. It's easier for me just to grab that jar and, you know, be done. I can have dinner for my husband in total 15 minutes and he's loving it. So be aware of those different points. And if I just rambled through this whole thing and you don't get any of it, please let me know, because I will try to redo it, okay? I hope everyone is having a really great Tuesday. It is raining. It's raining and it's been dark and gray all day long here. But tonight we're going to a string art class. So I will post a picture of our finished project on Instagram when we get home, okay? So have a really great night. Remember, if you like what we do here, please hit like, subscribe, hit that little bell, share with your friends. Please bring them to the party, because it's always fun. The more people that we have doing this, the more information that we share, and the better it is. Until tomorrow, have a really great night. Be safe. Bye.